Rhodes just exposing
The Miz here. And again, John, I'll ask you in your expertise, why would Miz take this match here tonight against Cody Rhodes? I mean, you said, you know, you show your strength and all that stuff, but clearly Miz has an opportunity to become United States champion this Sunday. Why do this?
It's a matter of pride. It's an alpha male. I have a lot of respect for Miz for taking this match. I don't think it's the wisest thing in the world to do. In fact, Miz probably should take the night off. He's 48 hours away from United States Championship match against one of the best United States champions of all time, Antonio Cesaro. This is not a smart move by Miz. And there's no way Miz is going to be 100% at Elimination Chamber in New Orleans.
And again, the Miz banged up as a result of Antonio Cesaro getting involved in what was a fantastic match going on this past Monday night between Cody Rhodes and the former WWE champion, The Miz. Now Miz! Starting to build some momentum here, almost with one arm. Miz looking for that combination. And again, Cody Rhodes has Miz well scouted.
Miz well scouted, he's got a freaking huge bandage on his shoulder.
Nice counter there by Cody Rhodes. Miz rolls through, misses wildly, rolled through here. Miz stepped up on his shoulders and stays alive at 2.5. And Cody Rhodes again, right back to the shoulder.
You know, I like the fact that Cody Rhodes and Damian Sandow broke up as a tag team. I think both these guys are a huge part of WWE's future as singles wrestlers.
Miz now looking for the figure four. Remember, this move was
Miz got him one
given
right in the middle of the ring
to the Miz by the Nature Boy Ric Flair. Cody Rhodes has to tap out. You gotta be impressed with what you saw from the Miz here tonight on Friday Night SmackDown. Banged up and all, Miz now heads to New Orleans to challenge Antonio Cesaro for the United States Championship.